Watch TV with best VPN in 2020. It's not that complicated. You have a data connection that is tied to your personal ISP and it can be used to view anything that happens on that device that you don't actually own. This has many negative implications and has even caused governments in the past to hold your IP address against you for law enforcement. You can be a terrorist or a pedophile, and your connection is tied to it. And so is your location. How do I know if I need a VPN? Go to the most recent VPNs rankings from Torrent Freak and you'll find the best VPN provider list of the most popular VPN providers with their open VPN ports, unencrypted UDP, and encrypted HTTPS. You need to then choose between the four most popular open VPN providers. Many of the top sites also do countdown and try to force you to get an encrypted connection if you're interested, making it easier to just go with the defaults. When did it become legal to use a VPN to watch TV? What about torrenting? The same rules apply. You need to have your service provider give you an IP address and a local DNS. However, there are many limitations here, especially with pirate sites that can be blocked. VPNs can also block your service provider if it knows you're using one. So if you're concerned about visiting such sites with your VPN, it's probably a good idea to use a VPN to protect you. But it's still best to use something like private internet access. You shouldn't worry about copyright issues with a VPN. It is similar to using an encrypted email, one where even if your email gets hacked, the hackers can't see what's in the mail. A VPN is just an encrypted connection, no different from a webmail service. You're just using a VPN to get rid of some of the connection issues that your ISP has no control over.